Now let's take a look at an example application, and that application is image stitching. So here's the problem. You have a three-dimensional scene, and you take a set of images of the scene from roughly the same viewpoint, but by rotating the camera. You're going to make sure that as you rotate the camera, the fields of view of the images that you capture overlap. So you want to take this set of images and automatically create a larger image. You want to stitch them together to create a larger image or a panorama. This technology, as you probably know, is now widely available. It's on pretty much all smartphones that are in the market today. But it's also used in other domains, such as medical imaging and remote sensing. So let's first talk about the problem itself. Imagine that you've captured these three images of a scene. And what you want to do is to align these images so you can stitch them together. So the first thing that you do is actually apply something like the SIFT detector to these images so you can extract features. And SIFT is perfect for this application. And then based on the SIFT descriptor, you're going to match features between images, and you come up with these pairs of matching features. Each of these white lines corresponds to a pair of matching features. Now that you have these matching features, you want to figure out what is the geometric relationship between pairs of images. That is, what is the transformation that takes you from one image to another image, so that you can take an image and warp it to the coordinate frame of the other image. That transformation is called the homography, and we're going to spend quite a bit of time trying to understand what that transformation is and how one computes it. So once you're able to do that, you can actually warp the images to a common coordinate frame. You just pick one of the images as your reference image and warp all the other images to the coordinate frame of that image, and you get a stack of overlapping images that look like this. Now, you're almost done with your stitching problem, but you have one last problem to solve, which is the problem of seams. Remember that no two images are really captured with exactly the same exposure. And even if you manage to do that, it turns out that the radiometric response of a lens varies slightly over the field of view of the lens. We discussed this earlier due to effects such as vignetting. And so you are almost always guaranteed to end up with seams that look like this between overlapping images. And you want to remove these seams so you get a single, clean, seamless image. And so that brings us to the topic of blending images. We'll develop a blending algorithm, a very simple algorithm, that in a sense removes these seams and creates for you a single contiguous panorama of the scene. So here's the problem we're trying to solve. Combine multiple photos to create a single larger photo. So the first topic we're going to discuss is image transformations. In particular, we are interested in figuring out what is the image transformation you need to apply to one image so that you can warp it and align it with another image. But we'll start simple here. We'll start with 2x2 image transformation matrices, and we'll see all the different things that you can do with just four numbers in the 2x2 matrix. And then we'll argue that a 2x2 transformation is not enough for what we are trying to do. We actually need to look at 3x3 image transformations. In particular, the transformation that we are trying to achieve is called the projective transformation, and it's given by a matrix, a 3x3 matrix called the homography. So now with that in place, we are going to develop an algorithm for computing homographies. So here we have a set of matching features in two images, and we want to compute the homography matrix that would allow you to align these two images and put them on the same coordinate frame. Now, there is a problem here that we have sort of ignored or set aside, which is the fact that when you take two images and you apply the SIFT detector, say for instance, and you find matching features, yes, many of these will correspond to valid matching features. That is, they would correspond to the same point in three-dimensional scene. But you will also have invalid matches, in the sense that you can have two features exactly match because they have very similar local appearances, but they don't actually correspond to the same point in the three-dimensional scene. So in other words, your set of matching features is going to have inliers, which are actually valid pairs, and outliers, which are invalid pairs. And we need to come up with a way of dealing with these outliers. So that brings us to this very clever, very useful technique called RANSAC. We'll show how the RANSAC algorithm works and how using a set of matching pairs, which include both inliers and outliers, as long as the outliers don't dominate the inliers, you can actually compute a valid homography from the data set itself and ignore the outliers. And then you can further refine that homography by just using the inliers. Very useful technique, and we will describe that in detail. So now we have all the tools that we need to actually stitch the images. We can take all our images, choose one of them as, say, your reference image, warp all the images to that coordinate frame, and then finally we've left with one problem, which is when you warp them and you overlay these images, you're going to invariably have some photometric or brightness differences between the images. We'll come up with a blending algorithm for removing these differences and creating a seamless panorama.